Mobile internet is changing everything, and we've heard a lot about that already today. It changes the way we work, the way we entertain ourselves, of course, the way we communicate, and also now increasingly the way we buy. Already, 1 in 4 visits to a U.S. retail site is through a mobile device. That's really a shocking statistic when you look back over time. Just a couple of years ago, it was a tiny fraction of visits to North American websites were through mobile devices. And the growth is expected to continue so that within a couple of years, the majority of your web traffic will be through a mobile device. Now, the mobile users want a bunch of things. They want it to work basically like the land internet. In particular, they want to be able to buy something on your site through a mobile device. They want to be able to get product information through a mobile device. Even more want to get store information, how to get there, the operating hours of the store, where it is. But here's an interesting fact. What they want most, even more than all those things, is for it to be fast. And in this case, the threshold is 5 seconds. 80% of the people want the mobile access to your site to be fast. And it's because people think about the mobile devices as being like the land device in terms of how it should perform. There shouldn't be any difference from their perspective. Now, you all know it's a lot harder on the mobile device. Now, to be fast, if you look at the land-connected sites, and you take Keynote's top 30 performing land-connected commerce sites, the typical page takes 2 seconds to deliver. Now, one interesting aspect about these 30 fastest sites on Keynote that they publish in their statistic is that all of them are using Akamai today. All 30 are using Akamai to make the site be fast. And so now it's down to 2 seconds. Now, you compare that to the 30 top mobile sites in commerce, as published and selected by Keynote, they are taking 9 seconds on average for a page to download. In fact, I look at the stat just this weekend, it was 9.9 as published by Keynote. And that's a huge difference. Now, in this case, they're not using Akamai's new mobile acceleration service, which we'll talk about. And that's a big problem because we haven't seen 9 seconds on the land-connected internet since 2001. This is 2013. You think back to 2001 on the internet, you're lucky if it even worked back then. And this is the state of the art today in mobile, and now the majority of your business over the next couple of years will be going to mobile. So that's a huge problem. And it's challenging for a reason. First, sites today, even mobile sites, have a lot heavier content than they used to. There's a lot of things you want to do with that site. You want to have a rich, engaging experience, even when it's on a mobile device. And you want to be able to do transactions on the device. You've got other people's content on your site. You've got ads. You've got maps. You've got maybe even local weather information. All sorts of content that you don't even control on your site, and that can slow it down and make it be harder to use. The code is not always efficient. It's not so simple anymore to make a website work. There's all sorts of JavaScript going on. You've got to schedule things. You're trying to collect analytics. And that makes it be inefficient. The protocols that are being used to get the site to the user, especially if it's a mobile site, are chatty, and that means lots of back and forth. Now, in the land internet, this is not so bad if you're delivering from close to the end user because the latency is low. So if you're using an Akamai service to deliver the content to a user, the fact that you have chatty protocols is not a big idea. If you're trying to communicate to somebody on 3G or 4G, there's even more back and forth going on, and the latencies are enormous. The distance between me to the local tower here is short in feet, but is over 100 milliseconds every round trip. And there's a lot more round trips on the mobile devices. That would be like trying to communicate to a website from here in Europe, in internet terms. Okay, so just as a comparison, to get to the tower, every round trip is like going from here to Europe on the land internet. And then finally, the mobile networks themselves are highly congested. And you all see this. In fact, we'll see it later today when we do a demo that'll involve the use of your mobile devices. And we're going to swamp the tower in all likelihood, so a lot of you won't get through. Go to any sporting event or you're in a major city, and the towers are congested. And these problems are because the internet and the wireless internet was not built for the web. It was built for voice. All those towers were created and are capacitated, and the protocols were built for voice, which is about 16 kilobits a second. And today, for your sites, you want to get at least a megabit a second of throughput. And the system just was not designed for that. Now, speed really matters. Your users want it, and if they don't get it, they're going to abandon your site. And this is a study by Gomez that shows the abandonment rates increase fairly substantially with the delays or the latency in getting your page downloaded. So if you're between like 2 seconds, which seems pretty fast, you've already got an abandonment rate over 10%. If you're out there in the range of 5 to 9 seconds, you're going to double that abandonment rate. And that's not good. Now, if you're fast, you're going to have a higher conversion rate. So it's the good news side of the coin. This is a study published by Walmart. And the blue bars are showing the percentage of their users that can download a page in a certain amount of time. And you see that a lot of the users are getting their pages downloaded in, well, 2 to 4 seconds. There's a few out there at the tail that take more than 15 seconds. And then you see the orange line is showing the conversion rate. And so if you can get really fast download speeds, you know, down like a second, you're going to get very good conversion rates. Once you start getting over 4, 5, 6 seconds, your conversion rate drops substantially. This means lost revenue for you. Now, Akamai has a new solution specifically designed for mobile sites, M-sites, and mobile applications called Aqua Ion. And it works in the similar manner. The basis is similar to how Akamai's normal services work, where we have positioned our servers in the internet all over the place. We're in thousands of locations on the internet so that we're close to every end user and we're close to your origin infrastructure. And if you use our services, we will intercept the request for your content or your application from the user very near to them, and we will transport it through our virtual internet back to your infrastructure, your data center, so that we can make it be really fast, secure, and reliable. And there's several ways that we do that. In the first mile, or the connection between your data center and our server near there, we will have substantial traffic offload, which reduces your cost. We can do this in part by caching a lot of your content. We'll offload your connections, because the only entities that connect to your origin infrastructure are Akamai servers that are near you. And so all your end user connections are terminating on Akamai service. We'll maintain those connections persistently, and we'll filter out all the attack traffic far away from your data center. That'll be filtered out on the servers near where the bots are and where the attackers are, and it never gets close to you. Then in the middle mile, which actually is the hundreds or thousands of miles, the vast majority of the distance between you and your end user, we built our own virtual internet. We use our own routing protocols. So we route around trouble spots or congestion spots on the internet. We'll route around, we use our own communication protocols. So we don't rely on the TCP problems with the congestion window and the fast backoff and the slow start. That makes much higher throughput, fewer round trips. We use our own compression, and we actually spend a lot of effort to get your content close to your user ahead of time, predictively figuring out what they're going to want and putting it near the end user. Then on the last mile, we'll sense the network conditions coming out of the tower. And so if you've got an end user who's got a small device in a congested area, we'll sense that and adaptively compress your images. So they'll still get a quality image, but a lot faster. We'll prioritize the content that comes above the fold, so the user gets a very fast first response for your site. We'll reschedule the JavaScript so things aren't hanging up the user's experience with your site. And we'll dramatically reduce the round trips to the tower. And those are the expensive round trips because they're 100 milliseconds apiece. This is what it looks like. This is the old Akamai service that many of you are using today, Dynamic Site Accelerator. And this is measured for 3G users, and it's the real user performance. This is not a keynote test or a Gomez test. This is real users going to a real commerce site. And this shows the histogram of their performance. And you can see that the real users on the 3G network are getting around 5 seconds page view time. Now, if this was measured in a data center, it would have been down 1 or 2 seconds. But on 3G, it's going to be slower. And if you weren't using DSA, this site before was having over 10 seconds delivery to their 3G users. And now here's what the new Aqua Ion service does to that site, as measured on the real user's device as they're visiting the commerce site. And so it takes that 5 second time down to about 2 to 3 seconds on the 3G network. And you can see what happens to the tail out there. It drops substantially. And so all that blue out there, which is better than having nothing at all using DSA for sure, those lost transactions now can be captured in the orange from the new Aqua Ion service, which is designed for mobile. Now, it's not just about your mobile site. And that's because 89% of people use smartphones now while they're shopping in your store or in combination with your brick-and-mortar store experience. And they're doing that for a variety of reasons. And these are all examples of commerce customers we have, what they're doing with mobile devices to help interact with the brick-and-mortar store. First, you can get navigation in the store. For large stores, it's sometimes hard to find what you're looking for, but once you're in the store, they can detect that and send you a map to find what you're looking for. They can give you promotional advertisement to say, hey, if you now go to aisle 18, and there's this product there that you can get a $100 coupon off if you buy it in the next 20 minutes. You can get information about the product that you're thinking about buying. Now, initially, brick-and-mortar stores hated this idea because you could do comparative pricing in the store and go get it somewhere else for cheaper. That was considered to be a bad thing. More and more, this is being embraced because you can actually get product information, which can help you buy the product while you're in the store. And if you find that the product is competitively priced, you're there, you'll just buy it. So now it's increasingly considered to be a positive thing in the brick-and-mortar store. And then finally, you can check out using your mobile device in the store. So the entire in-store experience now is being aided and facilitated by the mobile device and the mobile internet. And in fact, it's now being discovered that the people that do this spend a lot more than just a single channel consumer. In fact, a study from Marks and Spencer shows that, in fact, it's a big increase. If you're using two channels, 4x the amount of buying. If you use three channels, particularly two at the same time, even higher rate of purchase from your business. Now, because of this, stores are moving online in a big way. In fact, I'm not sure I know of any of our commerce customers who have brick-and-mortar stores that aren't very concerned about the internet connectivity in those stores. Now, there's two challenges here. First, it's very expensive. And if you're running hundreds of stores, or in some case, thousands of stores or branches, and you're trying to connect them with MPLS, that costs you a fortune. Second, the performance is not very good. You know, you think you're doing a good thing with getting a half meg or a megabit a second MPLS link, but before you know it, that's not nearly enough because you've got all your catalog information. You've got your in-store applications you've got to support. They're connected back to your main data center. You've got shoppers in the store that want to have a good Wi-Fi experience while they're in your store. And that means you've got to support that in the store, and they're using your bandwidth now. And if they're not having a good experience in your store, they're not going to stay there as long and buy stuff in your store. And so the demand for bandwidth into the store is increasing because of the performance problems, which cycles back with the cost problem that you're facing. This is an area where we're now working on a solution. We're in the very early testing phases now. The idea is that we want to place one of our Akamai servers or our software and put it in the store. And it comes on a very lightweight device, very simple. Just hook it into your store router. And what it'll do is now make it part of the Akamai network. And it will facilitate connectivity back to your data center so that you can do your WAN optimization, your WAN algorithms, and your internet access both. It's the full hybrid cloud capability. So it reduces greatly your costs, makes that MPLS pipe go a lot farther, and greatly improves the performance. It's the same kind of benefit you would get by using Akamai for your commerce site, by making it faster and more reliable and secure. But now it makes all the activity in your store, whether it's your private applications, your corporate applications, or just your buyers in the store browsing on the internet, makes it be fast and offloaded efficient and secure. And the early testing is very favorable, that if we go to a typical store, just to download a page in your catalog might take 8 seconds because of the congested pipe and having to go back to your data center. Now it could be done in under 1 second, which is a substantial improvement in making a better in-store experience. And the first betas will be offered in the second half this year, if you're interested. Now, this is just the beginning, and I think this is a very apt quote, that over the next several years, we're going to see more change in retail than we have in the last 100 years put together. We're just at the start. And here are just a couple of examples. Here's the shopping wall example, where you can just put up a piece of paper on a wall anywhere, in an airport, in a subway station, and that becomes your store. Because someone can scan the QR codes associated with a product, learn about it, and buy it right there online. Another one that's a lot of fun, and I want to actually show you, is called second screen viewing or couch commerce. Now, the motivation here is increasingly a lot of people, when they watch TV or watch a movie or a sporting event, they got their device out and they're doing something on the device. Maybe they're working, they're chatting, maybe they're surfing, and maybe they're in the mood to buy something. And this creates a great opportunity, sort of like product placement on steroids, that they can actually buy your merchandise as they're watching it in the movie or the TV show or the sporting event. Now, some of you are in companies where you actually pay for product placement. You pay to get your product in the TV show or in the movie. Or with a sporting franchise, they want to sell the stuff that people are wearing, what the players are wearing. And you then have to rely on the person remembering, going off later and buying, or having to get their device out, find your site, find the product, and buy it. But in fact, there's technology now, which I want to show you, that makes all this be automatic. That you can just have your second screen device, and automatically the device, the thing you're seeing that you might want to buy, shows up on that device. And you have one click to buy. Maybe you even have options where you buy based on where you live, and you can actually do it in a seamless way. So I want to actually show you this, and some of you can participate as long as we don't swamp out the cell tower. So if you'd like to participate, you can type in this URL to a browser, and you'll be able to play along with us. And let me ask Robert Neville to come up. He's one of the geniuses at Akamai that's actually built this demonstration to show you couch commerce in action. So Robert, can you come on up? And we're going to need to, once you get that URL, it's just www.akamai.com/couchcommerce. If everybody does it, we're probably going to have a problem. My experience with this is those of you on the 4G devices have a better chance than the 3G. And if we could switch over the slide here to get started.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, Robert. Now, what Robert's going to do here is he's got a mobile device, all right, and the same as yours. And it's going to, when he types in that URL, it's going to hook it up into the Akamai network. You're going to go to a website that we're supporting. And on that website, we've got information, product placement, associated with a variety of movies and TV shows. And so on the screen next to me here, on the inner screen, you're going to see the TV as if it's your living room. Already, we have 21 people have gotten in. That counter is saying how many people are into the system, as if you're in our living room. And you're all logging in as guests because there's only one person in charge, and that's Robert. And Robert's in charge. That will allow him to actually select the TV show you want and so forth. And are we good to go, Robert?
Yeah, we've got 62 people, I'm counting, 67, 70. Now, in a minute, you'll see the user count will go to 1 because I'm going to log in as a user. And I'm going to authenticate.
And what he's doing on his iPad here is shown on the outer screens, yep. So you can see him. And since he's in control, he'll be able to do a little more than you. But you'll all be getting the same information back in terms of the product placements and so forth.
Okay, so can everyone see on the end screens what's on the iPad? Or the 98 people connected can see it on their devices? So this first part of the screen is a picker that lets me select content. So let's say I want to watch Mission Impossible. So there we go. And so folks who are connected should see what you see on the outer screens. It says Hyperconnected Living, Mission Impossible. And we are fighting with all of you for a bandwidth.
You won! I suppose they did.
Where'd you pick that man? He's never won a bloody thing.
Okay, let's see, I'll pause.
Say no more.
So I'm going to pause that. So a few things. First of all, I'm controlling the content on my television, and thank you all for joining me in my living room. So I'm controlling the content on my TV through the cloud. So my companion device here is making connection to an Akamai server in the cloud. The TV is making connection to the Akamai server in the cloud. And that server is uniting the two, is passing information back and forth to enable this experience. So You should see those 139 of you now playing along.
Now, yeah, so how many people are seeing that on their device, that when the movie got to that part? Raise your hand if you got that on the device. All right, a bunch of you did.
Okay.
Yeah, we got 143, so we're probably congesting the wireless to your devices. My guess is the 4Gs get through here. But because the movie got to that point, it is triggering to give information to you. Now go ahead.
And those of you who can't read it, it says, did you know Tom Cruise's then-wife Nicole Kidman suggested Thandie Newton, Kidman's co-star in Flirting, as the love interest for Ethan Hunt? She was cast before the script was written. If I think that's fascinating, I want to know more, click more facts.
And you can do this too. You can navigate separately if you want to get more information about Nicole here.
Yep. And it opens up an IMDb page, gives me more information. So let's say I want to go back and I want to resume playing. And now we're back into the movie.
I have to grab a drink. You still fit with the balloons?
And now, let me pause again.
All right, what showed up here on the companion device?
So this was her dress. There's a scene where she's wearing her dress. Let me see if I can pause it on a point where she's... you can sort of see the dress there. But when the dress pops up, it comes up and says, here's the dress, would you like to buy the dress? If you say, sure, I'd like to buy that. Well, let's say you have a profile on your device that has your preferred credit card information, size, shipping address, et cetera. You say, yes, I'd like that. One click, and there. Purchase, return. Oops, back to the movie.
You can speak as if I'm right by your side.
Where are you?
Mounting enclosure just off the track.
Okay, so same thing with the aviator glasses here. So let's talk about a slightly different experience. Let's say we're going to watch a TV show. So this is a clip from Big Bang Theory.
Maid of Honor Amy Farrah Fowler's amazing behind-the-scenes wedding video, take one.
So I'm pausing it. So this is an episode where she's going around with a video camera, and you might think, hey, would you like to buy a video camera? Are you in the market for video cameras? Now, you'll see that it's not an in-app or an in-experience purchase here. It's links to retailers, and you'll see that the Best Buy link is a link to Palm Desert, so we can take advantage of the fact that we know where people are located. We can insert local links, insert customized links based on their preference, et cetera. So if I click that, or if you click along on your now 177 devices, when it loads, it's a little slow. I hope we're not DDoSing Best Buy in. There we go.
Yeah.
So, got information for the local store. I can say, hey, I want to go there. I can shop online, etc. So, similar kind of experience. Let's take a sporting event. So we have NBA Finals, and we should see that in just a second. There we go. I'm going to jump ahead a little bit to where we have an event trigger. So in about 5 seconds, we'll see the event trigger come up. And
so what are they seeing
I'll
there?
Pause. So what you're seeing on the outside screens and on your devices is a link to the Miami Heat store. And it says, Miami fans, official pro gear, jerseys, and outerwear are available at the Miami Heat store. Now, as Tom said, I mean, this is product placement on steroids. You could, for example, if you want to do a promotion, you could say, while that game is playing, following this link, you save 10%, you know, driving sales up that way. All kinds of opportunities. And as Tom said, this is a proof of concept. This isn't an Akamai product that we're currently offering. We're really interested in productizing this. What you're seeing is an absolutely live, real demo. We're actually sending this information from the player out to the cloud. You're getting that information on your devices from the cloud. I'm getting the information to my iPad here from the cloud. And we've got that infrastructure live. What we do with it is largely up to our customers and partners.
So this is an ideal way for the commerce world, people with commerce sites, to interact with the media world. Because we know where in the living room, where you are in the movie or where you are in the TV show. And if you create a companion site, you can have triggers based that when Tom Cruise puts on sunglasses or Mia wears the dress, that you can now put a trigger that we will make that companion site, that device, show that actual entity, that product, on their device at the same time. And this can happen, you know, of course, at different times in different living rooms across the world. It's always a personalized experience. So for each TV, there's a QR code. Anybody in that living room scans the QR code, and now their companion device is linked to that TV.
And a link and a persistent link. So if you like, if I'm using this iPad in my living room on a regular basis, I pick it up and use it like my remote. I don't have to authenticate each time. New user would have to authenticate with a new device. But it's no different than picking up your TV remote, but it's a hyper-intelligent TV remote, essentially, that is, you know, an open-ended conduit to viewers with any type of content. And that's sell-through, that's product information, that's information about the content. And one of the things that Tom said that's sort of important is that all this requires is a browser on the companion side. There's no special application, there's no special software, we're not doing fingerprinting or watermarking. The player is sending information saying, this is where the content is currently being played. That information is used to map to an event that's then displayed on the companion.
All right, well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
If we could put the PowerPoints back on. So in summary, there's a few best practices to maximize the omnichannel opportunity. First, it's really important to make it fast, whatever the touch point is. Second, it's good to take advantage of opportunities from having simultaneous use of multiple channels. All the early studies show that greatly increases the buy-through. And finally, it's really good to engage your in-store, your in-physical store shoppers with a quality digital experience. Now, I'd like to invite everyone to visit our booth. We really value your input. It's how we figure out what to build going forward and how we figure out how to make our services better. You'll be able to do the Couch Commerce demo if you want. We'll have it set up out there. There's some white papers, and you'll actually be able to do live tests of your site on mobile devices through the MobiTest framework we have set up. And now I think we have a little time for questions. And I can't see too well, so.
Yep, please raise your hand if you have any questions.
Okay, where are we?
There's a microphone coming. If you just, we'll just switch it on the bottom.
Hello, okay. Hi, I'm Steve Ellison with HookLogic. And my question is on that, in that demo that you showed, could you talk a little bit about how you envision that scaling so that there's sort of a meaningful opportunity for the brands or the retailers that are taking advantage of that?
Yeah, so the idea would be you have a certain media, like a movie or a TV show or a sporting event, and then there's commerce companies that want to product place in this new sense against that. So you would create a site with time, you have the timestamps for the movie, and then those timestamps would correspond to your site. So your site now becomes triggered by timing events in the movie. So for example, you might know that Mia shows the dress or is wearing the dress at time 2.56 in the movie. You'd create a little mini microsite around that dress, what you'd want to have be there, and the lead into that would pop up whenever the movie crosses 2.56. Wherever people are doing that around the world. So you would create one version of your site that have time triggers on it, and we're playing. You know, we're distributing that movie, or we're hooking up into the DVR players out there, so we know whenever a particular home is at 2.56, and so we now hook them in on their companion device to your microsite at 2.56. And if there's multiple commerce companies that want to be in the same spot, then the media owner or the network owner or whoever's providing the video could allow that to happen as well. And the scalability, the technical scalability is what Akamai is all about. So we make that work in our cloud.
Any other questions?
No? Okay, thank you very much.
Thanks, Tom.